Hi folks, Will from MinIO, and in this video, I'm going to be discussing a new feature of the MinIO server, and that is the ability to use SFTP or FTP to actually upload and download objects. Now, in this video, we're going to talk about setting up FTP, we'll talk a little bit about setting up SFTP, and then I'm going to talk a little bit about the limitations of what you're going to see when you're running an FTP or an SFTP server. Now, one of the questions you may have is, why would I want to do this? The key use case for this is if I've got a legacy system that likes to communicate over FTP, SFTP, and there's no way for me to use S3, I can actually enable this so that my legacy system can talk to my MinIO server. Let's go ahead and take a look at how you would go about setting up FTP. So when you are actually going to go ahead and set up FTP as a service on your MinIO server, what you're going to do is you're going to add a flag to the startup command for your server. So I'm going to do a MinIO server here. And I'm going to be running this out of the local data directory. But what I need to do is I need to hand it this dash dash FTP flag. Now, we want you to do this very explicitly because, as you know, FTP is not the world's most secure protocol. And so we want to make sure that you are doing this very explicitly. It's not enabled by default. You have to enable it here. And you give it the address you want it to respond on. And I'm going to have it respond on 8021, right? FTP is the old 21 port, but I'm going to use 8021 here. I can use whatever port I like. And this is going to bind to all addresses on the system. And then I'm going to run this against my local data directory that I have here. And what this is going to do is going to fire this up for me. And you can see right there at the last line, MinIO FTP server listening on 8021. Easy enough. So now when I want to actually connect to my server, I can use any FTP client that I happen to have handy. I'm on a Mac system here, so I actually have LFTP available. That's a very common LFTP client that's available for Mac, Linux. It's available pretty much everywhere. And I'm going to connect on port 8021. And I'm going to give it the user FTP user. Now, this is a user that I have set up in my system already. This user has read-write access. That's all the access it needs. There's no admin functionality available over FTP. There is no way to administrate the server over FTP. So you don't need any of the admin services anyway. Read-write is a good starting point for your user. And we're going to connect to localhost in this case. It's going to ask me for my password. And once I am logged in, I can do all the common things that I want to do. I can take a look at this bucket, for instance. And here in the bucket, I can see that I have this one object, a version PNG. I can do a get versioned PNG, no problem. And that's going to just download that for me. I can also upload it if I want to. Okay, so that's a very simple use case using FTP. If I have certificates enabled on my MinIO server, I can use FTPS. It will use TLS so long as my client, my LFTP client in this case, is actually enabled to use TLS in order to secure the transmission. Now, that said, if I don't want to use FTP, if I want to use SFTP, I can do that as well. So let me go ahead and shut this down and we're going to clear it out. Okay, so for SFTP, it's the same MinIO server command that we ran before. Now we're going to give it the SFTP. And once again, we need to tell it what address we're binding to. And we'll just bind this on 8022. Remember, SFTP is really an extension of SSH, so we may as well just use port 22 here. And since it is using SSH, I have to give it a private key so that we can authenticate back and forth. And so I need to add this second flag, SFTP, SSH, private key, and that's all dashed out there. And I'm going to use a key that I have set up specifically for this. Now, this is the private key. I've called it MinIO SFTP. And this key is something that I created using SSH keygen. It's very easy to do. And I'm going to, again, connect it to my data directory. Now we can see, there it is, our MinIO SFTP server is listening on 8022. So if I go back to my other window and now I want to use SFTP, SFTP, I give it the dash P for the port, 8022. And I need to tell it that I'm connecting as FTP user because I'm not logged in as FTP user here. So I need to make sure I'm connecting FTP user at localhost. And it's going to go ahead and connect out. Now, I've already used this key one time, so I'm not being prompted to accept the key. If I was doing this the first time, I'd be prompted to accept the key. But FTP user at localhost, I'm just going to give it the FTP password again. And now I'm connected and I can do an ls and I can see that I have all of my files here. I can cd into the bucket directory, and I can get versioned png. There we go. And that's fetching it to my local. Easy enough. So now I can use FTP and I can use SFTP. Now, there are a couple limitations to this. The first being, notice that I called this object versioned PNG. This is in a versioned bucket. Let me show you that. If I'm using the mc command, I can do an mc version info on the demo bucket. It is versioned. And if I do an mc ls versions on demo bucket, I see that I actually have a few different versions of that object. Now, FTP and SFTP have no idea how versions work. That's not what this is for, right? This is to allow your MinIO server to serve to a legacy system. And those systems are probably not going to know how versioning works anyway. If I need to use versioning, I need to use an S3 enabled client. And LFTP and SFTP just are not that, okay? So I'm not getting any access to all these different versions. If I upload a file, it's into a versioned bucket. As long as it's a new name, it'll make a new object. If it's the same name, it's going to create a new version. But that's all going to happen transparently as far as SFTP is concerned or FTP is concerned. So that's one of the big limitations there. Another limitation that we have is that your credentials are still being controlled by Identity and Access Management. That's MinIO IDP or LDAP or OpenID if you want to use that. All of that stuff is still supported. I just need to be able to log in. Now, I don't need to give the client any kind of admin rights. There's no way that I can do admin activities over FTP or SFTP. All I need to do is ensure that my user has sufficient privileges to list buckets, get objects, put objects, whatever I want it to do. Read-write is a good place to start. That's where I've started here with my FTP user. It has read-write permissions. But the other thing to keep in mind is that there is a limited number of operations that you can use. Get, put, ls are all there. I can do a make dir, rm dir, that's really creating buckets. I can do deletes. I cannot append, and I cannot rename objects through FTP. Okay, there is no way for me to do that. So it's very basic support. Gets, puts, ls's, make dirs, rm dirs, and deletes. That's it. That's all I can really do with this. Okay, so that's some of the limitations. But if you have a legacy system that really requires you to have FTP or SFTP services available, here you go. You don't have to change everything just to be able to use MinIO. You can still use MinIO with your legacy FTP clients. And that's everything that I've got for this new feature of FTP and SFTP. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can connect with us using any of the methods you see here on the screen. Or you can chat with us interactively on slack.min.io or just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.